Loading your stream now. Loading your stream now. I see picture. I don't hear anything.
Loading your stream
now. Oh,
now
I do. You switched to a different tab and now I hear it.
Yep, I was, had to, I'll tap real quick to turn off the background stream because everything was repeating.
Yep.
Anyways, I went to the controls real quick. I think I got them according to how they were in System Shock 1. So.
Oh, you want to make them according to how they were in System Shock 1?
Well, yeah.
Okay.
Well, the way I was playing it. Anyways, let's do a new game then. Normal hard. Alright.
Look at you, hacker. A pathetic creature of meat and bone, panting and sweating as you run through my corridors. How can you challenge a perfect, immortal machine? In 2072, a rogue artificial intelligence, known as Shodan, lost her mind. In her limitless imagination, Shodan saw herself as a goddess, destined to inherit the Earth. That image was snuffed out by the hacker who created her.
February 3rd is the day the magic happens. The Von Braun, the first starship in history capable of traveling at faster than light speed, will undertake her maiden voyage. This incredible journey is the result of teamwork between the UNN Protectorate and the incredible scientific minds of the newly relicensed Trioptimum Corporation. Imagine being able to travel to distant star systems in a period of weeks. It's all part of Triop's commitment to the future. The Von Braun is packed with over 1.8 billion flight, scientific, and security systems. Nearly all developed by Trioptimum and its wholly owned subsidiaries. Providing security for the Von Braun as she plows through the heavens will be the UNN Rickenbacker. At her helm will be no less than Captain William Bedford Diego himself, hero of the Battle of Boston Harbor during the Eastern States Police action. This incredible union of government and corporation is made possible by an intricate series of docking mechanisms that will allow the Rickenbacker to piggyback its way into jump space. Sleek. Fast. Revolutionary. Who knows what wonders await our crews in the bosom of the cosmos? All we do know is that it's a great day for mankind.
This is Dr. Marie Delacroix of the UNN Von Braun. We've been hijacked by an unknown force. Ship security has been compromised. Do not allow the ship... Repeat, do not allow the ship to leave under any circumstances. I don't know what we're up against here.
How'd you like that?
Interesting.
Welcome to the Ramsey Center UNN Recruitment Facility. Please watch your step when leaving the train. The grav shafts at the end of the hall will take you to the street-level training and recruitment center. Please proceed to the grav shafts.
Fucking Trioptimum. Guys, I haven't learned yet, have you?
Before you choose your career, you'll want to learn some basic abilities.
Hey,
Step into the grav shafts to proceed to street-level recruitment.
This ain't a grav shaft, this is a repulsor lift. What the fuck you talking about? Fucking Trioptimum. Guys, I haven't learned yet, have you?
Before you choose your career, you'll want to learn some basic abilities.
Hey, before you go into training, mm-hmm. go back out to the street level and look in the window of that Happy Noodle restaurant.
Proceed to the advanced training area.
Happy Noodle.
I just want to look at it, because apparently they made it look more like a restaurant and less like a barren room where somebody's sitting down.
Someone's enjoying food and a shiny steak out on the left.
Yeah, it actually looks like a restaurant now. How about that? I mean, mm-hmm. not an expensive restaurant. It's still just got a counter, but at least it looks like somebody is doing something in there and it's not just an empty room. Cool. Why don't you make it so that run forward is just W and walk forward is shift W?
Yeah, that's how it's set right now.
You don't have a fatigue level.
That's how I got it set. So I guess I go through basic training first.
Double check your controls?
Sure. I can hold down. Huh? I set that to shift. Oh, W. Okay. Let's try this. Yeah, I'll walk if I hold down shift. Okay. Anyways.
To pick up some basic skills you'll need to get by in the service, enter this Cyberlink booth. Inside, you'll learn the basic skills you'll need to get started. Welcome, trainee. While you're in our virtual training courses, we provide you with a simulated cyber interface. This training interface is identical to an actual military-grade cyber interface. Now, let's try it out. Move the mouse. See how it changes where you look? That means you're in shoot mode. Hit the tab key. This puts you in use mode, where you can use your mouse to interact with items in the world. Open your primary MFD, or multifunction display, by clicking on the MFD button near the bottom of the screen.
Uh-oh.
This display shows your strengths in various areas. When you're ready to continue, press the tab key to go back to shoot mode.
We'll fix it after I go through this.
Try changing between modes until you get the hang of it. Follow the red path along the ground to the next training station. To pick up items, center them on your screen and right-click. This will automatically place that item into your inventory. To view your inventory, press the tab key. You can move items around your inventory by left-clicking and dragging them around. To drop an item, drag it from your inventory into the 3D. To use items like buttons and computers, center them in your view and click the right mouse button. All usable items will have brackets around them. Highlight the button on the pillar and right-click. This will activate the lift. Try it out. If you can still see your inventory display, it means you're in use mode. Hit tab to return to shoot mode. The object before you is a med hypo. Pick it up and then press tab to go into use mode. Right-clicking on the med hypo, see the crate in front of you? To search it, center it on your screen and right-click. If you are in use mode, simply move the pointer to the crate and right-click. To take an item from that container, simply left-click on it. This will automatically place that item in your inventory. To close the container window and return to shoot mode, one of the most important tools you have as a soldier is your PDA. This device stores audio logs, emails, and other useful information. Click on the disk icon near the bottom of your screen to bring up the PDA display. Currently, the contents of your PDA are...
This message is coming from the audio log you just picked up. You can use your PDA at any time to play any audio log or email you've received. In the field, the PDA is also used for keeping track of your current mission objectives.
Okay, I'll go ahead and restart this and apply that fix. Alright, how to fix, Okay, that's pretty much what I had to do to fix the game. Okay, it's set. I'll start the game up and have fun.
Yeah, I recommend going through all the training areas just so you know what you're doing.
Yep.
Welcome to the Ramsey Center UNN Recruitment Facility. Please watch your step when leaving the train. Step into the grav shafts to proceed to the street level recruitment.
By the way,
mm-hmm.
I think that strafe running is a thing in this engine.
Yeah, it feels like it. Hard to tell. Alright, good. Just making sure my mouse is still working. That's my concern. Alright, let's do this.
Before you choose your career, you'll want to learn some basic abilities. First, you should go into... To pick up... Welcome, trainee. While you're in our virtual training courses,
we provide
you with a simulated cyber interface. This training interface is identical to an actual military-grade cyber interface. Now, let's try it out. Move the mouse. See how it changes where you look? That means you're in shoot mode. Hit the tab key. This puts you in use mode, where you can use your mouse to interact with items in the world. Open your primary MFD, or multifunction display, by clicking on the MFD button near the bottom of the screen. This display shows your strengths
much
in various
better.
Areas. When you're ready to continue, press the tab key to go back to shoot mode. Try changing between modes until you get the hang of it. Follow the red path along the ground to the next training station. To pick up items, center them on your screen.
Yay,
and
Twitch broke again.
This will automatically place that item into your inventory.
You love doing that
to view your inventory, press the tab key. You can move items around your inventory by left-clicking and dragging them around. To drop an item, drag it from your inventory into the 3D view, and release the mouse button. To use items like buttons and computers, center them in your view, and click the right mouse button. All usable items will have brackets around them. Highlight the button on the pillar, and right-click. This will activate the lift. Try it out. If you can still see your inventory display, it means you're in use mode. Hit tab to return to shoot mode. The object before you is a med hypo. Pick it up and then press tab to go into use mode. Right-clicking on the med hypo will use it and restore some needed hit points. Your hit points are displayed by a bar in the lower left corner of your screen. Many objects in your inventory can be used by right-clicking on them. The object before you is a med. See the crate in front of you? To search it, center it on your screen and right-click. If you are in use mode, simply move the pointer to the crate and right-click. To take an item from that container, simply left-click on it. This will automatically place that item in your inventory. To close the container window and return to shoot mode, press the tab key. One of the most important tools you have as a soldier is your PDA. This device stores audio logs, emails, and other useful information. Click on the disk icon near the bottom of your screen to bring up the PDA display. Currently, the contents of your PDA are empty. Now, pick up the audio log in front of you.
This message is coming from the audio log you just picked up. You can use your PDA at any time to play any audio log or email you've received. In the field, the PDA is also used for keeping track of your current mission objectives and obtaining help information.
Now it's time to learn about jumping and mantling. To jump, simply press the space bar. Some surfaces can be mantled onto by holding down the space bar. Mantling lets you pull yourself up to ledges and other high places in front of you. Give it a try. To climb a ladder, simply walk into it and look upward. You'll automatically start climbing the ladder.
I do like that mantling thing. It's pretty cool.
That was actually a feature that was originally coded for Thief.
Yeah.
This is the same engine that Thief is, uses.
I was looking through the thing and I saw him mention Thief. I'm like, oh, this is just the Thief engine. Alright.
You've done well. Remember, if you're unclear on any aspect of what you've just learned, if you've completed basic training, you're ready for the advanced level.
Alright, wannabe. If you want to learn the weapon skills it takes to even think about joining the Marines, come on in. We're looking for a few good men. Now we'll teach you how to handle a firearm. Pick up the pistol and the clip from the table. You can equip the weapon in one of two ways. Bring up your inventory and drag the pistol to your weapons equip slot near the right-hand side of your inventory. If that's too slow for you, you can use the hotkeys on the keyboard. Press 2. If the pistol was in your inventory, it will equip for you automatically.
That's a bug.
To lock and load the ammo clip, hit the
when you
R
entered
key
the booth, he should have said, good to have you on board. Once you've loaded the firearm,
take a shot at the dummy robot by pressing your left mouse button when in shoot mode. Notice how its health bar gets shorter as you chip away at it. Some items need to be charged with energy before they can be used. Pick up the laser pistol. Now use the recharging station nearby. The recharge station will juice up all of your energy-based items. Weapons, batteries, you name it.
Yep, each item individually has its own charge level instead of relying on a single internal battery.
Weapons are not fine wines. They do not get better with age. The colored dot on the lower right corner of the screen tells you what kind of shape your firearm is in.
Every weapon has an alternate fire mode.
Green
if you
good,
hit O,
red is bad.
It will allow you to switch to the
other
soldier
with maintenance skill.
Like the laser pistol has an overcharge mode.
The condition of his weapon.
I see that.
Just pick up the tool, open your inventory, and drag the tool onto your pistol. Remember that maintenance tools are only good for a single use. Good work. Now you're ready for the Marines. Take a look at the other training areas first before you enlist. They might...
Inside, we'll teach you the basics of some technical skills you'll need in the Navy. Welcome. You'll notice when you're in the Cyberlink booth, we'll provide you with a temporary cyber interface and the skills you need to accomplish the training tasks. But they'll only last. The object in front of you is a container of nanites. Nanites are consumed whenever you perform technical tasks, such as hacking or repairing. Welcome. You'll notice when you're in the Cyberlink booth, we'll provide you with a temporary cyber interface and the skills you need to accomplish the training tasks. But they'll only last so long as you're in the booth. The object in front of you is a container of nanites. Nanites are consumed whenever you perform technical tasks, such as hacking or repairing. When you pick up the container of nanites, they do not go in your general inventory, but are instead displayed in use mode on the bottom left of your screen. Walk over to the keypad by the door and try out hacking. Use the keypad by right-clicking on it. To the right of the number pad, you'll see an orange tab labeled Hack. Left-click on the tab. Text will appear indicating the difficulty of the hack and any bonuses that apply.
Are you pretending you're talking?
You'll see a grid of nodes. Clicking on a node will either turn it bright or dark. To successfully hack, you must connect three bright nodes in a straight line. Beware the ice nodes with the red outlines. If one of these turns dark, you fail the hack, and you might break the item you're working on, or worse. You can restart your hack attempt at any time by hitting the reset button, though you'll have to pay the nanite cost again.
Hey, open up, bastard. Well, I gotta hack it again?
Try just right-clicking the keypad. Oh, yep, you do have to hack it again.
Ah, bastards.
Oh, it's hacking practice.
Mm-hmm. You can use nanites to buy items from replicators. To use a replicator, right-click on it, then left-click on the item you wish to purchase.
Hi there.
The
Please
item you
make
purchased
your selection.
Will drop into the slot below. Make sure you pick up your purchases before you leave.
Thank you for choosing Value Wrap.
You learned the basics of the technical skills. There are several other technical skills you'll learn throughout the course of your career, such as repairing items and modifying weapons. The cyber interfaces for these tasks are similar to the hacking interface. Before you enlist in the Navy, try out the other training courses. They'll be useful.
Inside, you will learn how to reach out with your mind. Do not let fear block your path.
Sounds like the Advent.
We've provided you with a virtual interface and
that's the voice
ability
I was impersonating
to project simulated psionic
go.
Powers. Once you leave this area, these powers will be lost to you. The red bar at the lower left of your screen tells you how many psi points you have. Psi points symbolize the current ability to use your psi powers. Psi hypos replenish your psi points. Try using a psi hypo and watch your psi points increase. When you've reached your maximum in psi points, move to the next station. This psi amp amplifies your psi powers and lets you project them into the real world. To equip it, pick it up, and then hit the tilde key. Firing the psi amp activates your currently selected psi discipline. You currently have access to two disciplines, cryokinesis and kinetic redirection. Go into use mode and click on the arrows on the bottom right of the screen. This will cycle through your available psi disciplines. Later, clicking on the arrows above the number to the left will allow you to select psi disciplines from higher tiers. Use cryokinesis to destroy the robot and kinetic redirection to pull that nanite container towards you. Be careful. Holding down the mouse button can augment the power, but holding it down for too long will cause burnout, which will damage you. If you run out of psi points, use another psi hypo. Mastery of the mind is a slow but rewarding process. Return to this area if you need more guidance. Before you enlist in the OSA, it would be useful to experiment in the other training courses.
Well then. Yeah. Recruitment officer.
Here's where you make your choice, soldier. Here's where you enlist in one of the three branches of the military. Once you decide on your branch of service, there's no going back. A shuttle will take you to a UNN orbital space station, where you'll receive a briefing regarding your yearly postings. Good luck.
Tough decision.
Well, what do you think you would enjoy doing in this game?
Obviously blowing stuff up, but I know hacking is needed as well.
Yep, and like I said, all that choosing a career path does is it gives you a head start in a particular area of gameplay. The Marines will make you more deadly with, ranged weapons and stuff like that out the gate, but you could then spec Navy right afterward if you wanted to. And the Navy does have combat training and stuff like that. It's just the Marines do it a little bit harder.
I think it OSA is just mostly focused on the psionic stuff.
Yeah, there's some stat boosts and some tech boosts, but it's mostly focusing on getting psi powers and working on your psionic abilities.
Oh, I might go with Navy then. I mean, if I can train my weapon skills up and everything, then...
Yeah, yeah. Anything is accessible to you. It's just you get a head start in a certain area choosing a career path.
Look at that cinematic. Hey, ugly. Hey, you. You're ugly.
Yeah. That's one thing that's really dated about this, is how ugly everybody looks. Because of how few polygons they take up.
Yeah.
There was a pretty strict polygon budget back in the day.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome aboard the space station Chesapeake Bay, sailor. It looks like you've picked up some standard weapon skills at basic on Coronado Island. Now it's time for your tour of duty. Your tour will consist of 4 postings over 4 years. In this man's Navy, you're given a choice of 3 different postings a year. It's up to you to decide what kind of career you want to have, so choose wisely. Just approach a shuttle bay to receive a briefing on a posting. If you think that posting is right for you, head into that bay to accept the assignment.
No. Huh. Does this have any differences?
What's that?
The postings?
Yeah. If you walk near the each bay, he will give a description of what the actual posting is from a lore perspective, and it will tell you what it increases as far as stats and skills.
The UNN Lucille is looking for volunteers for their military police detachment. Those sailors can get pretty rowdy on these year-long cruises, so you better not be afraid of a tussle. The UNN Lucille is looking for an engineer's mate to help maintain the ship's core energy systems. There's some heavy lifting involved, sailor, but you'll learn your way around the high-tech equipment. The UNN Lucille is looking for an ops training officer to learn the ship's navigation and data control systems. You'll get your feet wet with the high-tech systems, but also expect some heavy lifting. The UNN Lucille is looking for volunteers for their military police detachment. Those sailors can get pretty rowdy on these year-long cruises, so you better not be afraid of a tussle.
Just use your own intuition as to what you think would do the most good.
Oh, I think repairing stuff might...
The UNN Lucille is looking for an engineer's mate to help maintain the ship's core energy systems.
Oh man, look at that cinematic. Look at it!
Oh, that's awful. I forgot about that.
Oh wow, it just keeps going.
Yeah, there are 3 different years or 2. By the way,
well, maybe not as
let me know
as
when you step into
the
shuttle bay
Fort
on the second
Bush.
One.
There's a lot on the second one.
Here.
Well, when you step into the shuttle bay.
The UNN Pierce is ferrying liberated political prisoners back home from their detention near Saturn. The Pierce has been assigned a detachment of Marines and needs sailors to load, administer, and maintain the arms on board the ship. The UNN Carfax is undertaking a mission to examine a newly discovered Class B comet approaching the outer solar system. You'll likely pick up some useful skills working with the high-tech navigation systems. Laverne, Florida hosts the Navy's premier tactical training school. While maybe not as respected as the Marines facility at Fort Bush, there's a lot to be learned here.
Oh, I'm about to step in.
Okay.
So,
when you get back into the mission posting area, when it drops you back in, look to your left.
All right. God. All right, I'm looking to my left. What the fuck?
It's an Easter egg.
What the fuck? Oh boy, more training.
The Navy strongly encourages every sailor to undertake some amount of zero-G training. A year at the Yamamoto Space Station in Earth's orbit will more than suffice. The Navy maintains a survival training school on the surface of Io, the third moon of Jupiter. Pros? There's no better way to improve stamina and survival skills. Cons? The 21.2% mortality rate. The Navy's Marie Curie Research Facility on Aquinas IV is currently conducting research on a new strain of space-borne virus that killed 220,000 citizens of New Atlanta. To lift the quarantine, we must determine how the virus pierced the city's micro-nanite shielding.
Oh no, there's another Diego.
That's actually Edward Diego's son. Or, no. Grandson, I think? No, son.
So you're telling me that slime ball had a child?
You have clearance for landing on the Von Braun in Shuttle Bay 2. Welcome aboard, soldier.
Steady yourself, soldier. This is Dr. Janice Polito of the computer ops staff of the Von Braun. You're safe for the time being. You're recovering from the effects of surgery and will be unable to remember any of the events of the last few weeks. You're on board the starship Von Braun and something's gone very, very wrong. Some kind of force has hijacked this ship. That's why you volunteered to be implanted with some experimental cybernetic implants.
Please, this ugly dude.
Rely on your cyber interface. It just might save your life. You must find an elevator and come up to Deck 4 to meet me. Deck 4. Can you remember that? But keep your eyes open. They're after us both now.
Right, Deck 4.
Watch out. I'm getting strange readings from that radar dish outside the window. It's become unstable due to... Move! Take cover!
Door's very broken. This door will open.
Key for the wrench is 1, by the way.
Okay.
The entire sector is depressurizing and the blue vacuum shield won't last long. Get through a secure airlock before you're sucked into space. Move it!
Access needed.
Codes out of Cryo-A again. Like I've got nothing better to do. I think Grassy just likes to make work for me. I'll set the new code to 45100. That should be easy enough to remember.
Warning. Decompression event.
Do you remember
imminent.
How the first code in
Please
System Shock 1 was 451?
Mm-hmm.
Decompression
That's
event
where it makes
imminent.
Another appearance.
This power cell is dead. There should be a recharger nearby. Just use it and it will recharge all the power-driven devices in your possession. After you've recharged the cell, plug it into the auxiliary power unit. That should open the airlock door. Be quick about it. The vacuum seals won't hold up much longer. Good. You've managed to get out before the whole area depressurized. I've just uploaded you some cybernetic modules. You can use them to upgrade your cybernetic rig at the upgrade units in this area. There are 4 types of units in the next room. 1 for each subsystem of your cybernetic gear. Stats, psi, weapons, and tech. But use the modules carefully. They're hard to come by.
Oh, I see.
The different difficulties that you select when starting a new game, one of the things that's affected is how much upgrades cost.
I think I'm saved. No confirm or anything like that. Oh yeah, this room.
Yeah, when you pick it, it applies until you... Well, it kind of holds it until you close out of it. Once you close out of the window, the choices you've made are applied. But while you still have that window up, if you made a choice that you didn't want to make, you can hit the undo button and it will undo it.
Needed. Oh great, the fucking ship's haunted.
You might witness some strange phenomena. Your R-grade cyber rig has an experimental perception enhancement that can theoretically detect residual psychic emanations. These emanations traditionally come from the recently dead. Literature might call them ghosts. I call them self-hypnotic defects in the R-grade unit. Fuck. Don't let it distract you from the job at hand.
Let's see if I can do this. Yes, I can. No, I don't want to be inside of it. Try again. Okay, here we go. That worked. I'll try again. There we go. I got a speed booster. For speed. Yeah, sure, it took a little bit of damage, but... Okay, this opens up.
Hey, Doc. A security bot showed up with orders from you to place this grunt into the recovery freezer. I'm no cyber doc, but I know a plant job when I see one. I suppose you know they outlawed R-grade cyber goodies after that fiasco back on Citadel Station. But hey, I just work here, right?
Huh. Oh, it doesn't say it's a bullhole. I am sad. I kind of do miss that System Shock 1.
Where it tells you verbosely what everything is?
Yeah, because it's kind of interesting. You kind of make up, like, what the area is. Apparently, the space bar is a system access! Huh, Xerxes. Kirkies. Xerxes, whatever. Xerxes.
Are you playing 300 again?
No, I'm just reading a little thing down there. Wear protective clothing. I don't have any. Piece it free. Alright, well, I explored all I can up there.
Well done. I'm uploading some more modules.
You managed to go through that room without having the thing you need, even in your view at all.
Fucker?
Oh no, you did. Okay. Never mind.
I just drank something. Turn down the music.
Yeah. I actually end up turning it completely off, but it's your choice whether you want to leave it on or not.
Give me... Oh, yes, no. I can still smack people. I just hold them to the bow for now. Oh, weapons. Pistol. Ammo. Nanites. Bottle of vodka. Hell yeah.
Unable to get in touch with
alcohol,
this place is falling
restores
apart.
Hit points,
of my
but takes away twice the side points.
The leaks in the venting shaft shorted out the primary
cigarettes
access
restore side
channel,
points, but take
we'll
away
all be on auxiliary power until we can get it back up. That means all the lifts are out. Marie. That insipid computer Xerxes has shut down the elevator as well. You can transfer power at the engine core on deck one, which will get the elevator up and running again. But you can't use the elevator to get down there. Wait. There's some kind of maintenance access right on this hallway. You can use it to reach deck one. However, it's locked, and Xerxes is hiding the passcode from me. Dr. Watts should have the code. He's probably in the crew subsection. Grassi has the key to get in there, but he's in the medical subsection, probably near the biopsy lab. Now get to the medical subsection and find Grassi.
Alright, chill, bitch. Damn.
Thank you.
access denied from a crate. Fuck you. It was delicious.
Oh yeah, food like chips will restore a small amount of hit points without any undue effects. Well, not short-term ones. Long-term, you might suffer from health problems in your 40s or 50s.
Oh, yeah.
Damn. The power outage has also taken out access to this bulkhead. It's the only way to get to the medical subsection. Pick up the battery from the floor and find a recharger. The one you used before is in hard vacuum now, I'm afraid. But there should be another one on this deck. Once you get the battery recharged, place it in the auxiliary override.
Stay down. It's good for your health. Oh my god, it keep coming!
It's because a camera saw you and tripped an alarm.
I see the camera. Ah, there you are, fucker.
The target of an intruder alarm, if you can find a security station and use it, it will deactivate the alarm.
That's what I'm trying to find right now. Let's see. Nah, this ain't a fucking security station.
Silence the disco.
Security terminal, I suppose, is the correct term.
Yeah.
Security alert terminated.
Oh, well, it just turns itself off. Okay.
Yeah, it goes for a certain amount of time or until you turn it off.
Back here to see what's up. Damn it. Alright, nothing here outside of the plant. Which I just picked up. Oh, that's great. Hold on. Hold on. There you go. Oh, so it's that. Okay. I guess. I got the fucking monkey shooting my balls at me! The fuck was that? Fucking monkeys. Alright, I'm not in combat right now.
Okay, pull up your logs area. There should be a category for notes.
Nurse
Lesser, and that will show you in brief the important information that you gleaned from the logs and the emails.
Oh, neat.
This wasn't just a random display. It was a protest.
You can basically use the notes section of your logs thing to act as your memory, I guess. Maybe check that when you come back to the game every day, you know?
Yep.
If you can't remember clearly what you were doing last time, you just check the notes section.
That's good that they did that. Access denied. I want out.
You have to find your way out.
I didn't kill anybody. Let me out. Oh, cool. What the hell that did? Oh, restore power. Something down there. I was hoping.
Please make your selection. Thank you for choosing Value Wrap.
Yeah, kinda do need bullets just in case more fucking monkey sonic bastards.
By the way, there are explosive barrels.
Oh, cool. I'm looking at them. Research software, okay. All those things that were on the zombies or hybrids, whatever, I can research them.
Oh, okay. The organs?
Yeah.
Yep.
Each deck has a chemical storeroom where you can find the resources you need to research the artifacts you'll find around the ship. Don't try to carry around all the chemicals at once. It's impractical and unnecessary. Your research software will tell you what chemicals it needs, and when.
And when.
Alright, so I should be gathering up those stuff then, if I can find any dead bodies. Hi! Oh, now I'm getting ammo, of course. My shit rolls here. Oh, I know where I am.
This is Xerxes. Remember, the unauthorized usage of firearms aboard the Von Krohn is a Class 3 infraction.
Ow! My face.
Having fun?
Yep. Face! Ow! Jeez. Ow! Face! Ow! I looked over, I saw a turn, I was like, oh shit. Oh man, this game is more cruel than System Shock 1. Oh man. I'm just taking my time looking around. I'm still getting my ass shot at.
Turrets are mean. They're programmed to be mean.
What I have to do, blow them up or some shit?
Yeah, you can.
With bullets?
You may have noticed that you actually picked up a few rounds that were not standard rounds.
Aha! There's another fucker around here, where are you? Say it, Ed. Asshole, you better give me something good. That isn't bullets.
Was that zombie Arnold Schwarzenegger?
Yeah. Zero C's, you're a piece of shit. I think Showdown's better than you. Give me that. I need health. Alright. I don't need Psionic right now.
Psionic the Hedgehog.
Yeah. Let's see, I picked up a battery thing, I think. Yep.
Good work. Here are some more cyber modules. Spend them wisely. They're not easy to look.
No! I think I can go backwards. Unless she gave it to me. Oh. Oh, yes, I can. Where's the cyber modules, bitch? Well, she gave it to me.
Yeah, she did.
Okay.
You have 4 more than you did.
This lets you know that 21 looks like something from TNG. It's like Star Trek Federation thing.
Mm-hmm.
Good. You've managed to get into Med. Now find Grassi and get the keycard to the crew sector. He's the one who monitored your cryo sleep, so he might be interested in joining you, if he hasn't been butchered yet.
Intruder entering Medical Sector A. Intruder, the many demands to know your intentions. Are you allied with her? Do you not know of her intentions, of her history? She once tried to destroy your species. And now you do her bidding. Intruder entering Medical Sector A.
Ah, healing bed, yay! But it costs money to use, but yay! I heard you, Xerxes.
You might witness some strange phenomena. Your R-grade cyber rig has an experimental perception enhancement that can theoretically detect residual psychic emanations. These emanations traditionally come from the recently dead. Literature might call them ghosts. I call them self-hypnotic defects in the R-grade unit. Don't let it destroy
me right to the
job at hand.
Yes. Stay fucking dead, assholes.
This is Xerxes. Why do you persist holding the line of summoning?
Ah, my face. Jesus. Fucking monkeys. Fucking monkeys. I fucking hate monkeys. Assholes.
That no one listens to me. The security protocols on the Xerxes system are clearly immature. Some idiot hacked into the primary data loop last night and made Xerxes sing Elvis Presley songs for 3 hours.
You can hit the U key to listen to your last picked up log. The voice subsystem
offline.
Yep.
What would happen if someone with a real agenda got into him?
Marie, I've got to restrict access
French
to engineering until we can figure out what to do down
gorgeous.
There. It's just too hot.
Huh.
I don't know where all the hazard suits went, so I'm reduced to bringing down an armful of rad hypos. Those damn things always give me a headache.
These missions should have been scrubbed before it left Earth. We've been unable to contain the reactant coolant leaks on Deck 1. I've put an order requiring hazard suits down there. I know you think this would cause a panic, but it's better than giving everybody radiation sickness, don't you think?
I can't raise anybody down in engineering. With the lifts out, I'll need to get down there through the emergency conduit in the Psi Annex. I think the access code is in Watts' lab.
Oh, bullshit, bullshit, bullshit. I thought it was like glass he couldn't shoot through, but he did.
Do you really think they would station a turret behind bulletproof glass?
I thought it was like a force field, actually, at first. Shotgun. Broken. I don't have the means to fix it, so... Is there anything I need? Hey, body armor.
By the way, if the combat animations seem awkward to you, specifically the swinging of the wrench, they were animations lifted directly from Thief, when you would swing a sword. And in Thief, they worked a lot better because they were kind of meant to be awkward. You know? You weren't supposed to be doing combat in Thief.
Jammed. My pistol's broken. I'll try, I can't do anything with that. Hold on to it.
You do remember that you chose repair, right?
Yeah.
You might have the ability to work on it.
Oh, I see. It's kind of like hacking. Okay.
Yep.
Yeah, just kind of said fuck you. Try it again. This shit is bullshit.
Well, it is that you have, you know, very low skills and not much helping you, so maybe you do want to wait until when you have a higher skill rating and the nodes don't turn dark quite as often.
Yeah.
Radiation hazard.
I have to stay here for a little bit. Just looking. Okay, I looked long enough.
I noticed you didn't go check the little specimen area.
Why, where all the radiation's pouring out?
Yeah. The area has one fixed radiation level, so while you're in it, it doesn't matter where in that area you are, you're still receiving the same dose.
Oh. Looked, and nothing of interest.
Oh, there must be another irradiated area that's got something interesting.
I'm good at this dying thing. I'm not trying to, it's just...
The surgical beds, by the way, if you receive a significant radiation dose and you can get to one of those surgical beds... oh no, they clear toxins, not radiation. Never mind.
Deadly neurotoxins. Welder operating.
Whose idea was it to bring 150 chimpanzees on board anyway? The interest of science? What about the interest of hygiene? Does anybody have any idea how much crap 150 lab monkeys make in a day? The poor chimps. They come on board for the most historic mission of all time, and they end up being chopped into little pieces in the name of progress.
Why is it being done on a ship?
Helzer's question is, why did they have to bring monkeys on board? Why did it have to be monkeys?
I'm tired of these motherfucking monkeys on this motherfucking ship. Oh boy. Yeah, I'm gonna die.
Decontamination shower will instantly clear radiation.
Oh, I see. Okay. That's antitoxin. Alright. That's anti-radiation. Is there anything in there, though?
I think that body that's lying up in that morgue area has got something in it.
Yep, I got it. Take that shotgun and try to repair it. And they repair skill 2. So fuck you, take a shotgun.
Would you like a point of advice?
Hmm.
You want to know how not to have to deal with the turret? There's a back way into the room that it's guarding.
I see on the map, okay. Try to swing at it and try to get up there, kill it. Oh, I see the time left, okay.
Speak of the many pools.
Yep, just getting up there and hiding from them. It's one of the wonderful limitations about the AI in this game is they don't climb ladders.
That is, that looks cool.
Conceive.
Oh, Shodan. Never stop being weird.
Oh, you thought that was Shodan talking at you?
Well, you can hear her voice kind of slipping in, I think.
That's actually somebody else.
Oh.
Well done. I'm uploading some cybernetic modules. Find an upgrade unit as soon as you can.
Patient Watson died at 0240 of non-specific causes. Despite zero respiratory and brain function, the body is still displaying autonomous motor function, as does the parasite. At 0847, the patient even spoke to one of the nurses. Autopsy is set for 16:30, and then we'll see what makes this Lazarus tick.
There's nothing in there. Guess I was in there. Okay, that's where I came from. I don't think it's supposed to be down there now. Run. I'm running, kind of. Okay, I'm actually strafe running. But it's kind of like running.
It's running even faster.
Here we go, let's see. Okay.
Good. You've made it into the crew sector. Now find Dr. Watts' room.
Art servers, art server offline. Yeah, I can still change the picture.
Yep. That's just when it's got saved.
Transmission from the surface of Tau City 5. I've been in negotiation with Captain Diego of the Rickenbacker, and after some coercion, he's agreed to go planetside as a joint venture. Imagine, this historic mission might even become more historic. First contact. And who is there to get exclusive rights to all media, patents, and land grants? Trioptimum. Miri, I told you this would be worth it.
Anything to deal with Diego, it's not worth it. Any kind of Diego. Ooh. All the sodas and alcohol and Arbogare, yay.
You're in heaven.
Oh, I want to get in there. Oh, I can't. Let me in there. for the greater good.
I was just expecting you to be spamming that to the point where it just went.
Because I would.
Hurry! Run! Hurry, kill me!
Security system.
Goddamn Bronson and her stupid procedures. She's changed the code on the Med-Sci 2 sub-armory again. Now I've got to head back up to Deck 4 to find out what it is. Somebody's gonna frag her, but good someday.
No, can't get into that. Okay. I will, though.
Your flesh will welcome us. Kill me!
I was about to say, how the hell were they able to get Marlboro in there? A bottle of bubbly.
Bubbly, 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 bubbly.
Yep. Yep. Space looks neat. No guns inside. I want to repair shit. So I'll get that in a second. Bottle juice. Apple juice.
Juice. I can see the seam.
All right, there we go. 1 point of hack. That means I can start hacking shit now. Let me get the shit working. Fucker. Costs a little bit of nanites. Alright, well, at least it's three.
Yep, only three.
Huh. Oh. I destroyed the auto. I don't give a shit. I fucking hate that pistol. Repair it. I'll get another one. What's this? OS
yeah,
upgrade.
There are others. In fact, you had picked up another one at some point.
Yep. What is this OS upgrade for? What's all this?
There are 4 OS upgrade stations throughout the entire game, and they give you a permanent upgrade in some fashion. And you can choose 4 of them. One, you know, every, I don't know, couple or 3 levels or so.
Okay. Well then. Let's see what we got here.
If you use a security terminal and you hack it successfully, then for a certain amount of time, not only will all security cameras completely ignore you, but all turrets will be deactivated as well.
For that amount of time, or...?
For that amount of time, and as soon as the period that you have disabled them for wears off, they all wake up again. Now, I'm not saying that's what you want to choose for the OS upgrade. I'm just saying, you know.
Mm-hmm.
In case you were wondering, you know, what is the use of hacking a security computer?
It's a tough one. Because these are like perks, you know? You gotta choose a...
Yeah, they're perks.
Yeah. I'm waiting for that cyber simulation so I can get diagnostic repair modules. So I can repair my shit if they get broken.
Well, I think that's actually just a healing item.
Oh. Damn. What kind of modifications can you do to weapons?
Each weapon has two modification levels, and, there's a description of what you will do to the gun when you're about to modify it to a certain level. Things could include reducing the reload time, increasing the magazine capacity, decreasing recoil, and that's second mod, never mind. I was going to say, I think it also increases damage, but I think that's only if you have a particular mod that I've been using. But they generally make the gun easier and more convenient to handle.
Okay, with Tinker then. Cheaper modification. Which I think is nice.
Security forces have been alerted to your presence, intruder. The glory of the many demands your capture or destruction.
Safe. Okay, but it is. Why is there water on this level? On a ship, no less. Oh, spaceship.
Wow, you're incredible. Do you know that? I made this game where I tried not to make myself think about you. What a moron. I love you, Rebecca, and I've got the plan. I've been buttering up the captain to transfer me from the Rickenbacker to the Goodwill team on the Von Braun. Pretty soon, nothing will keep us apart.
I'm almost expecting, like, I go through that and I see, like, Sheldon's face or something. That's why I'm doing it.
Marie, I'm sorry I've been out of touch, but I've been working on that artifact Bayless brought back from Tau City 5. I've done a level 3 analysis on it. I think it's some kind of artificial intelligence. I've managed to pull an audio tag file out of its memory. I'll let you be the judge.
Sample.
speaking English.
This is Xerxes. Remember, replicator restrictions are in place for the good of all of us. All unauthorized database interactions will be dealt with to the utmost degree of the law.
Yeah, the deeds of the many, stuff like that. Ow!
Potential threat.
Fucker, you got a shotgun. Monkey, monkey.
Security alert terminated.
You must be a masochist. You left that security alert running the whole time.
Yeah. I can't get in there. I want to get in there.
Well, that's interesting. They changed the graphical effect for that force field.
Is it better?
Well, presumably that, like, well, not presumably, but previously that particle effect were single pixels being made red. From a distance, you could see the particle effect very clearly, but as you got really close to it, those little red pixels were moving across your screen so fast you really couldn't see them.
Whoops. So they fixed it then. Cool.
Yeah.
Is that
toxic hazard?
Oh, come on. Worms are a toxic hazard.
Yes, if you step on worm piles, they will infect you with toxins. And those toxins will persist in your body until you clear them in some way.
Oh, okay. There. Ooh, a pistol. Let me up there. Damn it. I can see it! There. I got a pistol. It's terrible.
hacker didn't have this problem.
Oh, you've got your own new set of problems as Goggles.
Goggles?
That's what the fandom has taken to calling him. He doesn't have a name, just like the hacker, but he does have an interesting set of combat goggles. Take a look around.
Good work. Here are some more cyber modules. Spend them wisely. They're not easy to locate.
Yes, you keep telling me that, bitch. Damn. Laser operating. Where? I want to see lasers. I want to blow stuff.
Hey, Helzer.
Yeah?
I'm going to give you another hint. Go back to that room that had the box in it.
Yeah?
At the end of the hallway, and take that ladder up.
Oh, there's a ladder. I haven't seen a ladder. Now I see it. Ugh. Okay. Ugh. Okay, we'll try that again. Okay, at least I didn't get hurt this time. Alright, Midnight. Woo! My health. I don't have any.
There's actually another portion to that.
Oh? I see it. Sneaky bastards. Shit! Okay, good. Ugh, climbing ladders is a pain in the ass. Okay. Ooh, a shotgun, that's fair.
That's fair.
Yeah, you can keep it. Modify skill 1 required. I'll be getting that. A large pump. Sweetest made large pump. Ooh. There we go, I got it pointing to that.
Please make your selection.
Having too much fun with the scroll wheel.
You're about to have a sugar rush. Talking about Discord, Helzer. Instruct this man. Tell him what's up.
I assure you it's quite impossible. You claim that one monkey signed the passcode for a supply closet to another, and the latter proceeded to open it. As I'm sure you know, there have literally been tens of thousands of studies of primate intelligence, and there's no evidence of behavior even remotely that sophisticated. So either you've single-handedly trumped the entire field of animal behaviorists, or you're badly in need of a vacation.
Well, fuck you too. Asshole. Surgical unit activation key. Oh, okay. It does that.
Just so you're aware, slotting a surgical unit activation key into an incomplete machine is permanent. You have no way of recovering that key.
Okay. That's nice to know. Let's see. Chemical storage now. No. What do I want to go to? It's that research and development, so I'm guessing I gotta go through a bulkhead or something. To science. Which might be research and development.
Yeah, what a concept.
Yep.
Yeah, this whole deck is known as MedSci. One deck below it, deck one, is engineering.
Worf!
The many sings to us.
Is there a jungle?
Just stay dead. Stay dead. It's for the better good. It's for the good.
Hi there.
Just stay dead.
Please make your selection.
No, I'm not making my fucking selection. Alright, that's two.
Please make your selection.
Oh yeah, about that guy. Yeah, you stay over there. Chemical room.
Oh my god! When you were in the middle of doing that, my Twitch froze. You overloaded my Twitch stream. Thanks a lot, you bastard.
With nodes.
You can see them rotating on your map.
Yep. Ow, open the pod bay door.
Disappointed me. Transmitting cybernetic modules.
Potential threat detected.
Potential threat detected. Security alert terminated.
Now with the cameras, when they see you, they have a suspicion period where they turn yellow, and that'll last for several seconds until you hear them make a certain noise.
Okay.
Dr. Watts is alive and in his office. He should know the code to the maintenance access shaft. Hurry! He's been badly wounded. Don't let him die before he tells you that number.
Maybe it requires a skill of one. I thought repairing it was maintaining it.
No, they're two different skills. Repairing it is after it broke. Maintaining it is making sure it doesn't break in the first place.
Hmm. Oh god, Diego.
Anatoly, there's only so much corporate calisthenics I can go through before I start to feel a little queasy, so let's get down to brass tacks here. We don't like each other. We each have our own motivations for undertaking this mission, so let me give you a little warning. I cannot be circumvented. I cannot be tricked. I cannot be manipulated. And I cannot be bought. You come at me straight and keep the fancy maneuvers for your next board meeting. Just because my father swam with the sharks doesn't mean that I do.
We shall see, Diego. We shall see.
You've got long-lasting suspicions, don't you?
Yes. Alrighty then. Ooh. A shotgun. Another shotgun. I join you here.
Come to a
silence.
Thank you for the soda. Sir, you got a terrible pistol. You can keep it.
Sure, you'll find great use.
A gurney in a surgical unit!
They're not dead.
No, you're not.
They want you, you understand? They want you as a host. Get away.
Dude, just get up and go over there. Get up and go over there! Asshole! Ow! My face. Shot in.
Welcome you. Just so you know, you only need one copy of a specific type of unresearched object.
Oh, okay.
All right, calm down already. The access code to the conduit is 12451.
Definitely listen to Watts' logs because one of them is really nice.
But let's grab a beer on the recreation deck afterwards. Sound good?
Like, I'm doing research and stuff.
Research complete.
Yeah, you can do more damage to those assholes. What is the point of this room?
Listen to the other log by Watts.
The time is 16:30. Autopsy subject A. Watson. Now we're going to make the first incision in... Hold him down.
I'm trying!
Giblets. So there's no point in this area.
Gonna leave the faucet running, you animal?
Yeah, of course. Because if I don't, who will?
I think once you drop down into engineering, that'll be a good place to save and stop.
Yep.
I do believe you will have spent 2 hours in this game.
Already did. Yeah, you stay right over there, sir. Stay right over there. Please, just stay right over there. I'll go around the other way. If there is another way. I'm just hiding here.
You're deciding which way you want to die?
Yeah.
The F key is the hotkey for switching ammo types, by the way.
Huh. So, what's the point in this fucking area, then? Whatever. I just wasted some precious ammo thinking I can go right through that fucking window.
Yep. Extra precious ammunition, being that it was AP.
Yeah.
Ooh. If only you had the maintenance skill.
Only if. But I took it anyways. Isn't it pretty?
Oh god.
What's down here? Oh yeah, this area.
Looks like something out of The Sims now.
It kinda does. Are you my mummy? Exactly, remember this area.
That's just another way into the crew section where you found Watts's key card.
Hey. Yep. Don't see me. You don't see me. But I know where you are. And I know you don't like slugs. I play Doom! Give me those bullets.
That beam that's hanging over that recessed area you were just in. Is there a ammo pack on top of it?
One second. Yeah, there is. I can get to it. How do I get to it? Oh, of course, gotta have psionic, probably.
Well, not necessarily. You might be able to do a strafe-running jump off the top of that ramp and grab it as you're falling.
Problem is, it's getting right at the edge. I got one. Ain't got the other.
Ooh, that was AP ammunition.
Yep. Right, that goes to crew. Elevator's there. I think. Doesn't exactly say. Power's not all fine, asshole. Ah, that's the place, okay.
using your notes.
Patting yourself on the back. Get down to
yeah,
do
you're
not
using
waste
your
time
notes.
Patting yourself on the back. Get down to that shaft engineering and reset the primary reactor core. That will restore power to the
to the other quadrants, probably. Yeah, we get the idea.
You're now on the engineering deck. Find the engine core and reset it. This will restore power to the elevators. I'm getting some kind of strange readings from down there, so keep your eyes open.
That's Linux.
Does it fill you with pride that Linux is what ships in the 22nd century are running on?
Zero C's is using Linux, and Showdown was actually Windows.
Oh, Jesus.
Alright, well, sir, so far, interesting game.
Good.